Morning everyone, this is Rajendran here joining from Bangalore. Welcome everyone to Trade Digital's daily market commentary. So today's date is 3rd February 2016 and time is 8:30 a.m. Before going to the session, I just want to know whether the sound and the audio quality is, audio and video quality is good. You can raise your hands and say that if the sound and audio quality is good. Okay. Okay, good. So I'm able to see some hands over there. So what we are going to discuss in the daily market commentary is we'll be going through the global sentiment. What are the how the global market has been performed and what is the general sentiment prevailing in the market, right? Followed by that, we'll be looking into the participation sentiment, how the participants are playing. I mean, whether they are in longs or in shorts, what sort of things they are doing on. Right, so we'll be going through some historical data analysis, and then we'll try to look what the participations are trying to do, and then followed by we'll be finally looking into the market profile charts. Right, during the market profile chart, we'll be discussing the key reference levels and where the market could auction, which direction, what we could expect, what are the key reference level we have to look out for, which direction we have to trade based upon the sentiment in the market. Are we going to do a gap down? And we also look into the volatility factor, right? So these are the key things we'll be going to discuss here in the daily market commentary. And in the trading room, so after the daily market commentary is over, by 9:15, the trading room will be starting off. So we'll be having an access to the trading room setup, the market profile setup for Nifty Futures. And throughout the day, we'll be discussing about market profile setup, how it is evolving, right? Is it in line with our views, or how to trade such market profile setup, right? These are the things we'll be discussing in the daily market commentary, and the live market setup, we'll be talking about the live trade setups, right? So let me go through the global sentiment now, right? Let me go to Bloomberg. So let me go to Bloomberg. So we think, see, right now crude is the one major killer here for the global sentiment. So crude was currently trading below $30 handle, right? So if you analyze recently, the correlation between the crude and the stock market is higher, and people say like when the crude is going down, stock market is also going down, right? So such sort of sentiment is prevailing in the market, right? So but eventually, it doesn't mean like every time the crude is going to go down, the stock market has to go down, right? This is a wrong perception in the market. But if you look into the current scenario, the correlation, there is a very strong correlation between the crude and the stock markets, right? But over a period of time, it will have a divergence again. So crude, if the crude goes up, the market, you can see market will do nothing, or market will do some sideways action, or market if crude is going up, it will, market could go down, or if the crude is going down, market could still could go up, right? But the general sentiment in the market is if the crude is going to go down deeper, stock market will also go down, right? And again, yesterday's US market, Dow Jones ended minus 1.8%, almost 300 points down there, and S&P ended 1.87%. Again, there was some strong negative sentiment in the US market. And Europe again, they are down another 8%, right? I think here, okay, here. Okay, let me, yeah, so European markets are down almost, so FTSE was down 2.28% and DAX was down 1.8%, and CAC was down another 2.47%. So more likely the same reaction we can expect in the European Asian markets as well. So Asian markets, currently Hang Seng was down 2.96%, right? And Nikkei was down 3.14%. There was extreme global sentiment there in the market. So this sort of thing will create a sentimental gap down, right? So what is the sentimental gap down? A gap down which is created because of the global sentiments, right? So let me go through the SGX Nifty as well. So let me go through the SGX Nifty as well. So we are more likely to see some sort of an 50 points odd gap down, right? And then if you look into the India VIX, let me go to India VIX. So India VIX was up around 2% yesterday, so 2.17%. There was a last minute sell-off in the market yesterday. So volatility was 18.28. So volatility is not that great, but it was still maintaining its previous volatility, right? So it's not going below 16 or 12, but still it's maintaining above 18 handle. And then looking into the open interest sentiments, let me go through the open interest sentiment as well. Go through the open interest sentiment as well. So what the open interest thing is going on? So this is the Nifty options open interest sentiments. What the people are more likely doing is they are writing 7,400 puts, and they are also writing 7,600 calls, right? So there could be a situation like that could be an tight handling, tight range bound measure between 7,400 to 7,600. This is one possibility what the market could do, right? And then if the 7,600 put OA is going to decline, then possibly we could see some different range bound action, right? So from the open interest, what we can understand from the open interest, we can identify what could be the possible range. It doesn't throw any buy and sell signal, but by looking into the open interest, it's a dynamical figure, it varies every day. Only one thing you can learn from the open interest is it could you can see an what could be the possible range from the open interest figures, right? And again, I can go to change in open interest sentiment, right? This says yesterday where the people had built their open interest. Right. So you can see the blue ones are the calls and red ones are the puts. So you can see people are interested in building 7,700 calls and 7,600 calls and 7,500 calls. So what does it mean? So the market is going up. Why these guys are building open interest? Because these guys are more likely to be they are writing the calls over there, right? And you can see 7,400 put open interest decline. And again, it has to be monitored today because the open interest picture says like we are going to have some expiry support of 7,400 on EOD basis. Does it mean so? Because since the data is very dynamic, if any decline in 7,400 or a considerable increase in 7,600 compared to 7,400, it's going to be a strong measure in the market. Because the sentiment as of now it is negative, it could turn negative forever, right, for next 3-4 days or whatever. So but the current scenario says 7,400 call is a 7,400 is an strong support in the market. So let's take this information carry forward for the shorter run, right? So 7,400 is a very strong support on EOD basis as per the open interest picture, right? And if I go to the participant-based open interest, participant-wise open interest, I can go down here. I can catch the participant-wise open interest. I can go to marketcalls.in, and from there, you can see an participation OI, right? So the participation OI figure says. So there are generally four dominant market participants are here. One is FIIs, foreign institutional investors, and then retail clients. DIAs and pros. Pros are nothing but the brokers and other exchange members, right? So mostly and those who deal with prop trading desks, right? So we have some historical figures here between the clients and FIIs, right? So this is client index futures. So what the clients are doing when Nifty is going down yesterday, the client had increased their shorts. You can see the green line. The green lines are the shorts here, and the orange line are the longs, right? So when the market was keep on going down, the client is busy in building their open interest in both calls and their both longs and shorts, but you can see the client is net longs. The clients are net longs. Overall, they are having more long positions than the short positions, right? So this gives you an overall picture about what the retail traders are doing, right? Do we need to trade against them, or do we need to inline with FIIs? So this is what we are going to check in the participant wise open interest data, right? This will give you a broader picture what the participants are doing, right? Why they are doing. So that kind of analysis we can come to that. So this is FIIs index futures historical data. So if you look into here, Nifty was going down yesterday, and the FIIs are closing their some of the short position, and they are also closing some of the long position. Means they are still not interested in somehow they are not interested in shorts. They are net shorts, but yesterday they haven't. When the market was when the markets are going down, they are not increasing their shorts. They are decreasing their shorts. Maybe the FIIs might have a view that a 7,400 might could hold for the day, right? So at this point of time, clients are showing some bullishness, right? Overall the scenario is some sort of bullishness, and the FIIs are showing some sort of still bearishness, but their confidence in the bearishness is not that great. That's what I want to say, right? And this is the third comes the index option figure for the clients. So what the clients are doing when Nifty was going down yesterday. So you can see the violet figures, the violet lines. The violet lines represents the put short. So they are shorting the puts, right? So they are shorting the puts. More likely they are the one who shorted the 7,400 puts, right? So they have you've seen some high open interest built up over 7,400 puts, and then 7,600 calls. So the 7,400 puts are more likely to be returned by these guys. So more likely the so it means the clients are showing bullishness in the options as well. So next comes the red line. The red line is nothing but an index call short. So they are shorting on the both the sides. So what this says is they are shorting on both the sides. More likely they are the one who are thinking like the clients are still thinking like market is still bullish, but they are shorting on the other side. They are shorting both calls and they are shorting the puts as well, right? So the client thinks like market could go up, and but still it could be range bound. This is what the overall net open interest figures from index futures and options says. Right? Whereas they are not busy in going naked longs or naked shorts, right? And when it comes to FIIs, what the FIIs are doing, the FIIs are again doing the same thing, right? They have an put long, so they have a naked put long here, right? So they are going naked longs in puts, so they are still considering overall bearish. Still the FIIs are thinking like the market could be still in the bearish mode, right? But the confidence level again, you can see that they are not increased their bets when the markets were going down. They are still they tend to take some profits yesterday. This is reflected in futures as well as in the option figures as well, right? Otherwise, you can see the other factors, right? They are again going short in calls and puts, likely like what retail traders are doing. So one thing is clear from the picture at this point of time, these are dynamic figures, it could vary every day. But what at this moment they are thinking is like, there could be a possible range bound movement between 7,400 to 7,600 zone, right? So how to deal with this? So what we'll be doing, we'll be going through the profile setups and we'll be explaining it. So I guess if you want to ask any questions during the session, or what you can do, you can log into your Twitter, right? You can post your questions. You go to your Twitter and you ask some questions, and then you hashtag it with TradeZilla, right? So I can put like this, ask your questions with #TradeZilla, right? So I'll be here to answer your questions. We'll be having a last 10 minutes of session will be completely dedicated to questions, right? If you have any questions, you can hashtag it with TradeZilla, and I'll be here to explain it. So, so TradeZilla, I can go down there and I can see the questions coming in real time. Right. So if you have, if you feel you have some any questions to ask about the things which we are discussing today, or the things which you are going to show in the, if you have any concerns with the trading room, or if you are not able to listen to it, or you want to ask something about the trading setups, you can hashtag it with TradeZilla, and I'll be here the whole day to reply to you guys, right? And so let me go through the profile settings. So let me go through the profile settings. So I'll be going to the Nifty Futures profile, right? So we have an very interesting setup today. Anyways, we are going to do an gap down opening. So prior to that, I just want to tell you what this are, right? So we'll be using two sort of profiles. One is a split profile. I can split this profile, right? I can split this profile. And I can see those letters. So these letters are nothing but an so every half an hour price movement. See, every half an hour price movement, say first half an hour, the letter A period will be starting, and then it keeps on moving. How the price has been moved in those range, the first half an hour. Okay, so then the next letter will form, and then the letter B forms, and then the market will be oscillating in that B period in this zone, and then C forms. You can see the price movement, how the price movement, I mean, how the price was trading in that range for that given half an hour. So why it's meaningful to understand it? Because it says lot many things about what the people are trying to do, right? I can split the profile and I can merge the profile. So if I try to merge the profile, it to me looks like an distribution. I can say how the price has been distributed. And one good thing is there is no time factor over here. We are not going to watch any sort of time factor over here, but we can identify a lot more things, what the participants are trying to do, where the market is going to auction today, right? These are the things that we cannot predict here, but we can say like some, there are certain places market will flow from one zone to the another zone with an high, very high probability. We can figure it out, like, yes, this could be the possible potential place where the market could end up today, or more likely tomorrow, right? So let me go through that thing. And red line which you are seeing, so I can zoom in and I can zoom out. When I'm zooming in, you can see letters. When I'm zooming out, you can see the blocks, right? So ideally, is the letters matter? No. If you are an intraday player, the main, reading the letters make more sense, right? Whereas if you are not an intraday trader, say you are a positional trader, you can even a block makes sense to you, right? So we use both. We use, sometimes we use the letters and we use sometimes the blocks, right? I can, and also I can scroll the charts up and down so that I can see the profile. If the if the day is going to be very elongated day, I can move back and forth in my screen, right? And the another beauty of this market profile is most of the times you'll be able to stay away from a wrong trade, right? So you know, because most of the time market, it will keep on giving clues every day, and then we can use those clues to identify the potential targets. And say if I am going to take a short today, right? I know I can have a very safer zone where I can go short, or I can place a very, I can figure out my trade location. The trade location is the one where I can figure out what is my safest point, where I can enter at the safest point, right, towards my view in the market. And the red line, the red brackets represent the value area, which says like where the price is going to trade 70% of the time, right? So you can see the yesterday the price has been traded in this bracketed zone, that is where the price has been rotating 70% of the time, right? This is what the daily distribution says. This is a daily distribution. It is not time dependent. So even though it is whatever the minute I am putting, the profile remains the same. If I am going to put an 1 minute or 30 minutes, so it is not time dependent, right? So every day we get such a profile. Every day we get such profiles. So who can take advantage of it? both a positional player or an intraday player can take advantage of these things. Right? If you ask me, I do both. I do both, depends upon what kind of opportunity is coming in the market. I do trade both intraday as well as I can trade both. If I am seeing any shorter term opportunity in the market, I go for an positional bets. Right? If I am seeing an intraday opportunity, if my rule says we have to trade only intraday, then I used to trade intraday. Right? And this is a daily profile, so every day you will get a profile like this, and we can try to understand what is happening in the market, or is the market is too emotional, if the market is too short in the market, so that we could see some possible counter action rally. So those kinds of things you can visualize here from the market profile. So market profile is show of visual rules. It doesn't give you any buy sell signal, but by looking at visually, we can identify lot many factors in it, right? So I can go through what is happening in the market, right? So we bottomed out. Let me go through the phase from where we bottomed out. So we bottomed out on 20th, right? So 20th we bottomed out. So you can see some price action here. You can see how the profile is looking. So if I'm zooming it out, you can see there was a red color O line that represents the open of the market, and the letter hash. It's a hash letter. You can see that the market has been ended over there. Okay, so the letter starts with O, and then immediately market came down, right? And it was trading bearishly, and finally there was a counter rally came in the market, right? However, if you are not able to visualize it, you can just right click and then you can split the profile, and you can see how the market had done its movement, right? So at the A period it came down, and B moved little upper, and then C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, market went and hit the bottom, and then there was a last hour counter rally in the market, right? So this is how the bottom came in over there. And then the very next day, again we seen some bearish movement from the open, but it haven't breached the lows. But one thing it formed, you can see the letter H and I. The letter H and I is somewhat closely, both the H and I lows are matching. So that means we call it as a poor low. Market is too short at that moment. Many people are thinking like market could go down, right? But what we are seeing here is a weak low or poor low. Some people call it as a weak low and some people call it as a poor low. And again on 20th, we seen some similar patterns, right? The H and L, I mean the on 20th, the letter K and L is not matching, but the K is one tick below down that. So again it is a sort of a weak low. So these are the zones which are more likely to be achieved, right? So there is a high probable chance that these zones could be achieved, right? So we don't know when, but these are reference points. These are our reference points. These are reference points. So we'll mark it over the chart and we'll carry forward the information to our trading scenarios. So these are the high probable zones where market will come down and test these zones. Okay, let me go back again. So what happens after that? After that we are having the valley area, the bracket zone. You can see after overlapping at the bottoms, the valley area started shifting on the upper side. So when the valley area is shifting on the upper side, it means the trend has been changed. Something has been changed in the market, right? So you can see after that, after valley area shifted on the upper side, again we've seen a counter rally coming in. So the counter rally started developing on 25th. Later what happened, again there was a sequence of valley area overlapping. So 25, 27, 28, you can see a valley area overlapping with a market that is completely moving in a sideways fashion. And on 29th again value started shifting higher. So what happened so far, the valley area has been overlapped at the bottom, and then it started shifting higher, and again a sequence of overlapping, right? So if the valley areas keep on shifting higher, that means we are in a trending market, right? So far on 29th, we again started shifting higher. After shifting higher, whatever this happens, they again started valley area, the valley area again started overlapping, right? So yesterday there was an because of RBI announcements, there was a no rate cut is going to be there in the market. Market finally fell down in the last moment. It came up with a spike. The spike is nothing but an last 45 minute action, so where the market is going to be completely moved down, right? That is a spike down. So we have some certain rules to trade the spikes, as well as today we are going to see some gap down opening. So the gap down is going to be some 64 points down, right? So should one have to go emotionally short in the market? If you ask me, I should say you have to wait, right? So it is not a good time to go thinking about short. At least you give some 10 minutes of time. So I'll tell you who is the one going to short in this market. Oh my God, the market is going to crash today, so it's going to be a black Monday. I don't want to miss the opportunity. So these sort of mentality, if you're going with it, then you're called as an emotional weak player. Right, so the one who are more emotional in the market is the one going to get hurt on the market, right? So if you have a mentality like, yes, today is going to be on Black Monday, I don't want to miss the chance, market is going to fail 200 points. Or you are a guy who is taking an bet in the market, like market already fell down 300, 400 points. So you want to enter at that moment, and then you're thinking like market will go down another 600 points because someone had told you that market would crash some 600, 700 points, they have a target like 6,300 or 6,700, and you are believing on that and you are taking an emotional bets in the market, right? So these are the players, the emotional players in the market are very often tend to get hurt in the market. Market knows when to punish them, right? So we can identify from those profiles whether the market is going to get too emotional or not. A gap down is nothing but an emotional situation, right? Because nothing has been changed from yesterday's market. Because of global sentiment, we are going to open a gap down. After gap down, what is next? Is the market going to move up or is the market going to move down? Right. So to understand this, we have to think about what happened on 25, 27 and 29. You can see I marked the reference level. This is the reference level I will mark over here. So three times whenever the price is hitting this zone, 7420 zone, we've seen a mechanical buying coming in. So mechanical buying coming in those zones. So at the J period on 25th, and again ABJ, and again price opened the gap down, but still it managed to close. It immediately moved faster. So it's here in market profile terms, there are no such thing called supports or resistance. Right, so once the support is broken and then it bounces back, that will become your actual support. So again, 7420 is an important zone. So I'll be looking for those zone after a gap down. How is the price going to move back above 7420? Again, are we going to see some mechanical rally coming in the market? Are we going to accept below 7420 and the price whole day is going to trade below 7420? This is what I'm going to look around for the day. Right, so let's see, let me go through SGX Nifty again. So SGX Nifty is pointing to 7404, right? So we are going to open closely above this reference level, right? So if market is opening somewhere here 7410 or 7400, and again it's going to pull back above 7420, that is zone I look for confirmation towards trading the longs, intraday longs. I'll trade only intraday longs. I don't carry forward my longs here because why I'm not carry forward, because we have an analytics. So we have an analytics, sentimental analytics indicator, right? So the sentimental analytics indicator is only open for the Tradezilla participants. So you can see we have an hourly sentiment and daily sentiment running on in real time. And you can see here the daily sentiment has been turned negative. So don't watch the colors, but just look at it as an oscillator perspective. The oscillator is highly smoothed oscillator. We call it as an Zurich oscillator, right? So Zurich RSX, we call it a Zurich RSX. When the indicator is turning from the peak to it's turning one step or one tick negative, that means the daily sentiment is negative. When the daily sentiment is negative, we don't appreciate and carry forward in the market, right? So if you long cannot be carry forward, but if you want to carry forward shorts, you can carry forward your shorts. But I haven't carry forward my shorts because I'm seeing an possible range bound scenario in the market. Right? So when there is a possible range bound scenario in the market, anyways, my rule says don't go long, but you can go short. But I'm not going short because the so far the scenario saying me you can wait for an long entry. You could get a potential long entry from the intraday perspective, right? So when the daily sentiment is negative, I look for certain clues to go short again in the market. When I will go short, when I'm getting an price is getting clearly accepted below 7420. When the price is going to clearly accept below 7420, this is a mechanical zone we are seeing, right? And the open interest players are not confident about 7400, and they are going to unwind some of their position. That is where I'm just going to take my positional bets, right? So what could be the potential target if 7420 is going to the price is going to move down below 7420 and the whole day we are going to trade below 7420. In that case this could be our potential target reference level. So these are the four low zones, so HI and KL, right? So it means there is high probable chance that this is going to likely to be revisited if this mechanical zone is going to likely to be broken today and the price is going to rotate somewhere here, right? So the other scenario is if 7420 is going to hold, market anyway is going to breach. Once it is going to breach and then it's going to pull back, right? That is where I look for some long opportunity. One long opportunity is towards the what I'll be targeting. So let me split this profile, right? I can see a couple of things. One is the JL are the matching highs. I'll call it as a weak high. Again, it means people are placing their stop loss bets over here. And again, I have another reference level at the top over here. So the EF period, I mean the DE period. Again, 7600, I'm seeing some stop loss coming in. Right? So I'm seeing a sequence of stop loss at the tops. So lot many people are the top four blue lines are where I'm seeing a lot of stop loss. People are placing mechanical stop loss over there. So more likely whenever the people are placing the stop loss, they are more likely to get punished, right? So if the price is going to move down and then it's going to swing back, I'll be going some intraday longs for that towards the first target of 7545, and then later towards towards whatever the market gives, right? So ideally 7546 could be my potential target if the price is going to move down and then it's going to pull back above 7420. I look for some acceptance, and later if the price is not going to dip below 7420, I'll keep on stop loss, and then I'll look for an potential long trade in the market because there was an extreme sentiment in the market. And again, if you see, you can see some anomalies over here. Right? So the market has to do some action over these zones, and so I'm seeing a lot of potential stop loss coming in. So the GH period, and we have one more JL stop loss over here, and we have one more poor high here, right? So I'm seeing a sequence of stop loss over here. So whenever I'm seeing such stop loss clusters, market tends to move in those directions. So to get a confirmation, I'm going to go see a dip in the market followed by a pullback, so I can target all those potential zones on intraday basis, right? If you ask me, can we carry forward the positions? No, I don't carry forward the positions unless my sentiments turn positive from here, right? The sentiment says yesterday the sentiment turns negative. Otherwise, the sentiment was still positive right from the bottom. On 20th onwards, the sentiment was positive, right? And then yesterday, the sentiment turned negative. So once it has turned negative, I don't want to take any bets against my sentiments. If I'm going to take any bets against my sentiment, it's going to be purely intraday, right? And again, we have an intraday sentimental figures as well to understand what is going on in the market, right? If the intraday sentiment is going to turn positive, that is the hourly sentiment. So likely we can see some counteraction rally coming in the market, right? So anyways, we are going to open gap down. Again, the sentiment is going to be weak. And anyways, I'll be posting those sentiment over the Twitter today. So we'll be posting, we'll be revising the sentiment every hour or so. So you can follow this hashtag, #TradeZilla, to understand what was the commentary going on in the market, right? And if you have any questions, you can ask me right away. So this is what my measure is. And one more thing I want to tell you for Nifty. So this is what the top line is, 7625. So 7625 is there. The people are again more likely to place their, again, I'm seeing some mechanical selling came thrice over here. So this is the place. So we're seeing a mechanical selling coming in. So when there is a mechanical selling is coming in the market, markets are more likely to revisit those places, right? So again, like today we are going to revisit 7420. Again, there is a high chance that we could see some 7625 as well. If the market is completely going to, when the scenario is going to hold, say when the market is going to, we are going to have an acceptance above 7420, right? And then we started moving up with a pullback rally. There could be a potential scenario that all the four stop loss, these are the four levels where most of the people are kept their stop loss, right? So if this thing is going to play out today, right, this thing is going to play out today, we can see all the four levels going to get cleared in 1 or 2 days. Otherwise, say if you are if the market is going to move down below 7420 and we are going to get some acceptance, anyways the sentiment is going to be negative, right? And if the open interest players, 7400 open interest players, are going to give up, or 7600 put option players are going to build more open interest, then the scenario might change and we could be in a trending fashion. The range bound situation can move to an trending mode. So then we could see these levels getting in 7270 and 7250. So these are the high probable zones where the market is more likely to revisit. So now the confirmation is coming over here, 7420, right? Any acceptance below this, we can see an downside level targets. And if the market is opening gap down, anyways, the gap rules will be applicable. If the gap is going to be very small, that's a high chance that the gap will get filled, right? So I'll be looking towards the gap to get filled if there's any pullback above 7420. Anyways, the gap is not that great, only 30 points from here. But my potential on the upper side, I'll be looking for the levels like, this is the first level I'll be looking for, 7545. This is the first level I'll be looking for my intraday long targets. Right? This will happen only if there is a market dip below that and then it pulls up. So let me take some questions. If you have any questions, you can ask me in Twitter. Today, the whole day, I'll be in Twitter. So you can use the hashtag #TradeZilla. Or see, I mean, market profile, if you want to learn market profile, it cannot be learned in a day or two. It requires at least 6 months of hard work, right? So it cannot be learned in a day or two. If you are coming up with an mindset in a, you want to learn something in a day or two and then you want to practice it, it doesn't work that way, right? At least so far I haven't seen any such person. Like, they learn something in 2 days and then they started applying the very next day and they started making money off it, right? So what I am believing is trading requires effort. It requires a tremendous hard work. at least an 1,000 hours of efforts you have to put it in the market. You have to be really passionate about trading systems to you have to be really passionate about your systems, your ideas, your ideology about the markets, your view about the markets, right? Unless it is not going to happen without any, if you are not putting any efforts and you are looking for some money, I mean, there is something wrong, fundamentally wrong with the way you are trying to play, right? So to motivate this, we came up with an intensive program. So we call it as an TradeZilla. So it's a 1 month program where we'll be going to go through all this how to view the market, how to view the market from a different perspective, and how we can see the how we can stay away from the crowd most of the times. And this is what we'll be discussing during the mentorship program. So we'll be mostly talking about the market profile setups, and then we have a complete agenda over here. For TradeZilla, right? So we have an same daily market commentary setup and followed by a live trading room journal. This will be happening on all the market days during the month of April, and on the weekends we'll be having the market profile webinars, as well as we are also having some AMI broker webinars, lot many AMI broker webinars, and we'll be having some AFL programming webinars. We have an 4 to 5 sessions of AMI broker AFL parts, and then we have some almost some 15 webinars are there, completely handled by me, right? So we have done such webinar setups in Divergence is a similar event which happened in January, right, where we also have some guest speakers, whereas the TradeZilla is a pure mentorship program from Market Calls. We'll be talking about AMI broker, we'll be talking about market profile. So we'll be using mixture of both. So we'll be using AMI broker software, we'll be using NinjaTrader software during the course, right? So if you have any questions, you can ask me down there. You can ask with an I'll have some questions. Market at 7390. So will you wait for IB to take decision or go short right away? So So we have another two more minutes left, right? So I look for the market to pull back above. I'll wait for market to pull back above. 7420. At least I look for some initial confirmation. What the market is trying to do, that's what we look over here. So if the market is going to open below 7390 and then it's going to pull back above 7420, then again market is not quite reluctant to go down. That's what I believe. So we could again auction on the other side. We can market could still move on the upper side, and it could take all the stop loss levels. So those people who shorted yesterday and then who are shorting fresh are more likely to get killed if 7420 is going to taken back again. If the price is going to conquer 7420, that is where I look for a very safer entry, right? And anyways, gap rules are going to apply. So if the gap is going to be really small, it's more likely to be repaired. That is one rule, right? So again, anything could happen in the market. But one thing is, if I'm going to see a strong acceptance below 7420 for the first 1 hour, right? So then I'll take my bets to trade shorts. If the perspective might change during that time, I'll be looking for my hourly sentiment to support me, right? So if the hourly sentiment is still saying negative, I'll take some carry forwarding bets towards this zone. So 7265 and then 7240. But anyways, if the market is going to dip below 7420, open interest has to give some clues for me, right? So anyways, so we opened a gap down over here. Let's see, what the participants are trying to do. So if the participants are emotional, right? So they don't want to miss the rally on the downside. So let's see what sort of confidence are there in the market. Still, there is no acceptance above 7420, right? So we'll keep 7420 as an acceptance level. The moment it switch backs up, that is where we look for a long entry. Otherwise, it's better you watch the market, what is happening in the market, you try to read from the market. So anyways, I mean, with this, I'm just closing the session. I mean, session will be still running live and you'll be having access to the profile charts the whole day, right? So we'll be running in a split profile mode and all the discussion will be happening in the Twitter. And if you have any questions, you can ask me in Twitter, right? So all the replies, you can get it over the Twitter. Or my Twitter handle is twitter.com/marketcalls_, right? You can reply to me as well with a hashtag of TradeZilla. We can talk the whole day over the Twitter, right? Yeah, thank you. So I'll be in a mute, so but still the I'll be in mute for the day, and any questions I can take it over the Twitter, and so whole day I'll be in the mute. So thanks everyone for your time. So the trading room starts right away. Thank you. And whatever the session we spoken today, it will be recorded and it will be posted in our blogger, right? So thanks everyone. Thanks for your time. Right. So have your time learning market profile in the trading room.